Hey guys, I'm Callie Lewis.
And I'm John P. On today's Geek Beat, a new way to punish the FCC.
Cats who save lives.
iOS on Android.
A robot that runs faster than you can.
And a road paved with solar panels. It all begins.
Between Dave and I, we have a mission to never allow you to say now.
I will never be allowed to do it.
It's because you try and tease the audience.
It's good. It's good when I do it. It's bad when you guys interrupt it. I don't know what to say.
How are you guys today? I hope your week is going well.
You know what? You look fantastic. I love what you've done with your hair. Have you lost weight?
Yeah.
You look good.
Thank you.
Well, you have on the Geek Fit program.
I have. I've lost weight. I haven't lost weight.
I can see.
I haven't lost weight.
Oh, okay. You've lost body fat.
My aggregate weight remains approximately the same.
Right.
But I have lost a lot of fat.
That is all that matters.
Fat. What were you going to say? You can see what?
I can see a difference.
Can you?
Absolutely.
You're looking good, too. You know what? Hang on a minute. This could be a trap. She could have been trapping me just now. Oh, you look like you've lost weight. You look really good. Then if I say to her, you look like you lost weight, what does she say?
What, was I fat before?
I can't win. I'll tell you what we do have going on. You know what you look like? You look like you're wearing a new t-shirt.
I am indeed wearing a new t-shirt. What do you think of it, John?
I like it. You have little cats on your t-shirt.
Yeah.
I don't know if they can pick up the subtlety, but that t-shirt actually appears to be kind of half, like, tone. Like, there's a slightly lighter gray on this side, slightly darker gray on that side. But anyway,
I'll tell you why.
It looks like it fits well.
Isn't that called an irregular?
Right. She doesn't get it.
I don't get that. I'll tell you why I am wearing a new t-shirt.
I have one too, by the way. But you didn't have to mention that, but that's okay.
Oh, I forgot you were wearing
that one too. I have a t-shirt on too. See, I've got a t-shirt.
It looks good. Actually, yours is way more even complicated.
Nobody cares.
Like, both of ours are pretty complicated.
Okay, tell them why.
So we are testing new shirts for our new Geek Beat shirt that you guys saw us launch this week. So the new Geek Beat tees with designer Jason Karn. Fantastic designs, but we had to choose new shirts for them because we didn't want to use the same ones that we used for the original DVTs.
Well, also because these new ones are a much more complex design. Look at that. And you said the shirts you saw us launch this week, but some people haven't seen that yet because they're watching on TV.
That is true.
So the announcement, folks, is if you go to geekbeat.tv, we just opened up the new Geek Beat shop. Go to geekbeat.tv/shop. Or just go to geekbeat.tv, you'll see shop up at the top, okay? And you will find two new, badass designs. That's one of them. That's the new Geek Beat Western Wear look. This is like what Geek Beat would look like if it was John Wayne.
If you're a Geek Beat patron at the $25 a month level and up, you are getting this design as included in your patronage.
Yep, that will come. But we have one other design. Do you have that one, Dave? We have another one that we're calling the Geek Beat Monogram Design. Look at this.
This one is super complicated. Intricate.
Can you zoom in on it? I don't know if the TriCaster has that capability. Oh, it does.
Yes, it does.
That is hand-drawn.
We had to find a way of printing. So our next step is to look at different printing methods to be able to get this complicated design on a shirt that looks amazing.
Wait, stop. Can you, right there, Dave, go back, zoom in on like the EIG. Can you zoom in more than that?
Nope, that's it.
Oh, that's the full zoom. Well, anyway, it's pretty darn zoomed in. I want you to notice the detail. Look at the E, these letters are hand lettered.
Yes,
they
are.
Now, like, look at the E and the G. There's even a little line outside of the G that, kind of emphasizes the curve. It's magnificent work.
It is.
Jason is a true artist.
So you go and you can order.
Oh, and you can buy these shirts. I'm sorry, I forgot.
At geekbeat.tv/shop or /store, either one.
I got distracted.
And we will be doing the modeling here shortly, as soon as we make our decisions.
Yeah, once we get the t-shirts.
This one is super comfortable.
Yeah, I'm liking this one. There's another one in the other room that's even a little softer for me. I kind of like it. I don't know. We'll see. We're going to get those designs printed on them, and after we do, and when we are satisfied that the shirts are awesome, then, and only then, we will have them printed and shipped to you guys, but you can order them right now. So go to geekbeat.tv/shop and do it. And also, check out our new building video that we just released like an hour ago on geekbeat.tv. And somebody has to pay for that building.
So we're going to go to commercial break, and you watch those, help us pay for the building. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Geek Beat Live. I took you out, John. Why didn't you bring us back?
Because you just interrupted me.
You were looking at me.
Just like
I saw out of the corner of my eye, you were looking at me, so I assumed that you wanted me to take it.
You interrupted me just like you did when I was trying to do the opening of the show and stuff like that.
All right. How about I stay silent and you take you
no.
launch us into news for
I
today.
Will do that because it's time
that?
To get to news. First up, the news of Microsoft launching a lower priced Xbox. Microsoft launches a lower cost Xbox One and cuts the live requirement for apps.
Yes.
So,
well, this happened because of a previous announcement that they did, and so they're trying to make everybody happy.
Here's the deal. You guys know I'm not a gamer per se. By that, I mean I like to play games, but I just don't do it because I don't really have a lot of time and all that other stuff. So, I am not the expert, but here's what I understand. Everyone was pissed off that Microsoft was requiring you to use Live.
Right.
And that did not make them happy. Because, like, I bought a game. Why do I have to go online to use my game and stuff like that, okay?
Well, anytime a company makes you do something in order use their service in order to do something,
you're going
to
get mad.
You're going to get mad. You just don't want to.
That's true. So now you don't have to do that anymore. So they dropped the price of the Xbox. But you know what? They didn't really drop it. The new Xbox One comes for $399, but they also, it doesn't come with a Kinect sensor. Didn't it used to come with Kinect?
You could get it with Kinect.
I thought it had to because it was gonna yell at you if there were like four people watching TV.
I thought it had to, but I just don't know. Anyway, it's now $399, so the question is, are you guys gonna buy it? If you didn't already have one, are you gonna buy one now that it's $399?
Well, it's the same price as the lower end of the PS4 model.
And gold subscribers now receive free games and exclusive discounts.
But you can do things like watch Netflix, Hulu, Amazon Prime Video, all through the Xbox One, of course.
Didn't they add Verizon Fios support to the Xbox a while back?
Yes. I think we did a video about that.
I think you can even use it as a tuner. So that would be cool to have one box to rule them all.
You could talk to it in that video we did. Callie was able to say, hey.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
And you can, like, wave your hand to change the channel and stuff.
Yep. That stuff is awesome.
I wonder if you were watching a show and you just didn't like the show, maybe if you gave it the finger. Would it change the channel? I don't know.
Well,
we don't know these
things. You take Pandora's thumb up, thumb down ideas.
Yeah,
apply
it's a finger
it
up,
way.
Finger
right.
down idea. Okay, I've got my.
Oh boy, I feel a rant coming on.
No, I don't have to rant.
Oh, okay.
It's my favorite story of today. Okay, some of you may be up on the fact that the FCC has. Our lives are not perfect in terms of net neutrality, and some people are upset about that. That's all I'm going to say. I'm not going to get into it. But you know who is going to get into it?
Who's that?
A hosting company called NeoCities has the best idea ever. They're mad at the FCC for what's going on, so you guess what they did about it, Callie?
What?
They throttled the FCC. What they did was... the owner, Kyle Drake, in protest to what's going on, has figured out a way to make it so that anyone visiting their sites from the FCC gets throttled to 28.8.
Wow.
It's like 1990s called, they want their internet back. And let me tell you what makes it even better.
That's a commercially viable decision.
Yes, I think it's commercially viable. Yes. Let me tell you what makes it even better. What makes it even better is he's going to make the code publicly available that he used to do this on GitHub. So the whole world, everybody can go and throttle the FCC. Let's see how you like it. I mean, the government wasn't thinking about that, right? Well, let's make them think about what happens when we throttle you. And if it doesn't work just throttling the FCC, let's throttle the White House, the Senate. Let's throttle everybody to everything. Everything.
Right.
Yeah, healthcare.gov, it's already been a little throttled. Okay.
All right, so if you ever post reviews to Amazon, which I know you do, John.
I do indeed.
I think about it.
Both good and bad.
I need to do more of that. Anyway, if you've ever done that, well, you know that people can vote up and down, right? So this user...
Thumbs up if it was helpful.
...called Trevely, he posted a review about MediaBridge. It was a company that he bought something, and it was actually a negative review. It wasn't a good thing. Mm-hmm. And then it became the most helpful review on that product page. So lots of people were saying, okay, this
that helps.
Review
thumbs up.
Helps. I'm not buying it. Bye.
That means it moves to the very top of all of the reviews. So what did they say? They said, hey, that's not fair. We don't like that. That's not a good review. We're going to sue you for libel. Which actually, if it's true, if that guy really didn't say things that were true in there, they could probably make a case that it was libelous.
Sure.
But if it was true, then that's a totally different story. But what did Amazon? Amazon steps in and says, you know what? You can't be threatening our customers like that. You're out of here.
Booted. So they are no longer allowed to sell on Amazon.
Good God.
Wow.
Hey, by the way,
but
could
that,
you guys...
But that was actually a smart move on Amazon's part, because regardless of whether that review was true or not, or it's actually libel, Amazon has to protect their customers and their reviewers, because they thrive on that.
Amazon owns the marketplace, not the companies in it. You're participating at their will, okay? By the way, you guys can go to badparkingcards.com and it will take you right to our Amazon page where you could leave a cool rating for our bad parking cards.
We haven't been booted off Amazon.
No, we haven't. Okay, and we have 1 minute left to tell you that Motorola is launching some new low-cost phones. That's right. You can get a phone.
How much?
Well, here's the thing. $219 without a contract.
Nice.
That's a good deal, because usually you hear like $219 with a contract. And then it's like $300 that they get reimbursed or something like that. But they're going to have LTE bands, 2, 4, 5, and 17 in North America on the Moto G.
Nice.
Which is updated with LTE service and with a micro SD card slot.
Or you can get the Moto E for $129 without a contract. It's a 4.3-inch screen, 960 by 540 resolution, 1.2 gigahertz dual-core processor.
So guess what this means?
Storage.
Here's
it's water-resistant.
Yeah, here's what this means, people. All of you who are walking around with an ancient 1980s-style brick Motorola phone, it's time to upgrade, okay? It's not like you even have to, you can be in the middle of your contract. You don't have to be like, oh, I have this old phone and I can't upgrade it because I'm in the middle of my contract. So what? Just go buy one for $129. And bingo bango, you got your new Android phone. All is good with the world. And it's time for a commercial break.
But before we go, we want you to chime in with the Fame Spot question of the day, which is, John,
what do you think about the FCC and would you throttle them?
Ooh. Go to geekbeat.tv/FameSpot to leave your opinion. We'll be right back. I feel like that I wasn't...
You couldn't just leave it at that?
I felt like it was awkward, so I just kept talking.
It's more awkward now.
Yeah, a little bit.
You want me to fade it back?
That would be great. Thanks.
Hey folks. Welcome back to Geek Beat Live. This time, Callie did not cut me off. I got to it before her. Oh, now you're just not going to talk at all, huh? Okay, that's fine. Just stand there and look pretty.
Oh!
I'll do this show.
Where's that sheetrock?
No, don't hit me with any more sheetrock. In case for those of you, we have stuff on the run sheet that we're supposed to be telling you right now, but instead of telling you that, I'm going to tell you that if you didn't see today's show, we did a complete walkthrough of the building.
Yes.
And I went over there innocently thinking, oh, we're just going to do a complete walkthrough of the building. And then she smashed a piece of 2x4 over my head. She smashed it. Now, on
it
to
was
today's
a piece
story.
Of sheetrock you can go on your
to
arm.
The. You can go.
You, over the door.
You are a terrible salesperson, okay?
Oh, go watch the video. I stabbed him.
Yes,
a lot.
Now, yeah. She stabbed me a lot. It still hurts. Ow. Okay, now on to gadgets. Gadget time.
Microsoft keeps making the news today.
Microsoft?
No, not Microsoft.
You're on the wrong section.
I am down below.
First thing we got to talk about is a makeshift holodeck. That's right. You heard me right. It's a makeshift holodeck. So there's a guy named Oliver Kralos who strapped together, I kid you not, 3 Kinects. And
an Oculus Rift.
And he turned it into a holodeck, basically. So he's walking around like, I don't really understand what he did, but as far as I can understand, he's got these 3D VR virtual reality glasses on. He's looking around at his room, and somehow he's also got like 3 Microsoft Kinects watching what he does. So when he moves his head, he's kind of interacting with his real environment, but it turns it into a virtual one or something like that.
That is really cool.
And
I want one.
He can put aliens in there and stuff like that and turn his real environment into some kind of a freakish game.
That is cool.
I don't know why he did that.
But because it's fun and it's cool.
That's a good enough reason.
You know something else that's fun and cool? Solar panels. So these...
They are, actually.
There are 2 people. You have lots of solar panels in your house. And Scott and Julie Broussard from Idaho, they decided that they were going to launch a campaign, an Indiegogo campaign, to pave the roads with gold.
Yeah, well, or at least with solar.
Yes.
So what happened...
How cool would that be?
Yeah, so he's an engineer, electrical engineer, and I guess his whole life he's just been fascinated with solar panels, and so he's basically come up with this prototype. As I understand it, he actually got originally some funding from the government, and he's taken this prototype down a path of building this thing, but now he doesn't want to stop. He wants to literally... pave all the roads with these solar panels. And what would happen is, first of all, these things kind of snap together like Legos.
Yeah.
And so if something breaks, you know, like if somebody were to break one of them, the ones around the broken one will send a signal back to wherever the control center is and say, hey, this particular one's broken. So they just come out and snap a new one in. So like potholes are a thing of the past. You just snap in new solar panels.
That'd be fantastic.
They're saying that if you were to wire up all the roads, these things would generate 3 times the power that is even consumed in the U.S.
Wow.
I have a hard time believing that.
That is hard time. That is, I mean, Idaho, it has some pretty nasty winters, so.
Yeah, it won't generate a lot of electricity, but then think about like Arkansas, or sorry, Arizona.
I was
Arkansas.
Like, what?
Arizona. Or Texas, we got a lot of roads in Texas, and you generate a lot of power, so you can move it around on the grid. But anyway, the question is it a viable option? Well, there's only one way to know, and that's to raise $1 million and give it a try.
Yep.
So they launched a project on Indiegogo. They've already raised $200,000.
They have about 3 weeks, right?
Yeah, they've only got like 2 or 3 weeks left. I don't think they're going to make it.
I don't think so, too. But, it's a very interesting project. So
hopefully
to tell you guys about
it. Yeah, and hopefully they can say, like, even if they only get up to, let's say, 500,000, they can then go back to the federal government and other people and say, look, there's clearly interest. We weren't giving people anything. They were just going to get their name like on a road, and they were giving, they gave us $500,000, but right. we couldn't collect because it wasn't enough. So why don't you just give it to us because people want it?
Yeah.
Why not?
Can we talk about Microsoft now?
Now you can talk about Microsoft.
I really want to show you this to you guys. This is pretty cool.
It's freakish. They... I don't understand it, to be honest. But then I don't understand many things.
Right. It's okay, John. I'm okay. here for you.
Thank you.
So Microsoft actually created what they call an infinity room. It's not like an infinity wall.
No.
That we'll have at the Geek House.
Which we'll have at the new building.
But this is a 15-foot by 8-foot mirrored room. At it's at the Embarcadero Center in San Francisco, so you can see it. But it's basically a way to explain big data and test Microsoft services and put them to good use. It's a big fancy way of getting attention, really, but it does its job.
It's really cool, but here's the thing. We're not going to sit here and tell you about this video. You have to go to... Bang, Dave.
Geekbeat.tv/live1
38.
Why
you got to go there and watch this video.
I think I'm getting old, John.
It's well done. This is one. See, Entrapment, she wants me to tell her, oh, no, you're not getting old. But then she'll use it against me somehow.
Actually, I think you called me old, pretty old. You said when a woman gets to your age the other day.
Yeah.
That was not. He did that riskily in the gym.
Guess what? Columbia students have built a really cool system called the CIDR Project, which allows you to take iOS apps and then run them on Android.
This is pretty cool, actually. So, you know, some people come to us, they're like, I can't decide between iOS or Android.
Just
what
get Android,
I get?
Run everything.
There you go. You could do it both.
I want to know how long before Apple sues these people,
right?
Sues Columbia University, sues everyone.
Yeah.
How long before they just squash this? But
it basically mimics the entire system.
It's kind of like a VM, but it has really better performance. The first thing I saw when I thought of this, I thought of like Parallels running on a Mac that lets you then run Windows on your Mac, but it really uses a lot of CPU and slows things down. Well, they were demonstrating this. It did not look like it was slowing anything down to me. So I don't understand how it works. They use big words. You guys should go to geekbeat.tv/live138, and you should watch the video because it's too cool for me to explain to you.
All right, and one other. Apple is also having some angry customers, so maybe that is a reason to switch to Android. But when Apple users do switch to Android, apparently they were losing all their text messages. They never got them because
they were using iMessage.
Yes.
So I have a tip for all of you people who are using Apple and wanting to switch to Android. First, switch off of iMessage. Why would anybody use iMessage? Use iMessage.
People like iMessage. I don't really like it.
Friends don't let friends use iMessage.
Right.
Ken is over here saying iMessage is good.
He loves iMessage.
No, it's not good.
You know, I don't want people to be able to see that I have seen their message.
Oh, you don't?
Although you can't turn that off.
You're stuck up.
No. Wow.
I want to be able to delay my response, you know? Yeah.
Oh, I see. You want to go all stealthy.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of stealth mode.
I'll remember that the next time she texts.
Right. Yeah, remember that. Speaking of stealth mode, it's time for a commercial break. I don't really know what that has to do with being stealthy, but we want you to tell us if you would throttle the FC. Given a chance.
I hit the wrong button.
Dave throttled the show.
He's gonna have
would
to
you do
edit
that to the FCC? If you would, head on over to geekbeat.tv/famespot. We will take your snarky and ridiculous commentary and we'll put it right here on TV beside my snarky, ridiculous commentary. Welcome back to Geek Beat Live.
I thought that was my turn. Okay, fair enough. You can take it.
I am just kidding. That's Callie Lewis, the wonderful and talented Callie Lewis.
That's John P. You know who else is wonderful? Our pets.
Pets are wonderful.
Don't you love pets? They are just
I love dogs.
Fantastic creatures.
I love dogs.
Well,
usually this particular dog, not so much.
Yeah, not
we are
so
going
much.
To tell you guys a story and show you a clip. But before we show you a clip,
we have a disclaimer.
Yeah, if there are small children in the room, send them out of it. If there are adults in the room, send them out of it. Don't watch what we're about to show you, even though it has been watched like 17 million times on YouTube, because
right.
This is a story about a hero cat named Tara.
Yes, he's from Bakersfield. And
he or she.
Tara, girl, she. So a little kid was playing on his bike, on his tricycle.
We'll let the video speak for itself.
All right.
Cover your eyes.
It has impact.
Here you go.
There's the dog.
Okay, there's a dog. There's a kid.
This is from home security camera footage.
There's a dog. There's a kid. The dog.
There's a kid.
Holy
what?
Mother, bite. I mean, why?
Oh, and
did
the
you
cat,
see the
Tara
cat?
Just rushes him off.
Chase the dog off.
Although, can you back that up a little bit?
Look at that.
Okay, so.
First of all, what in the heck is wrong with that dog?
I don't know. That dog was just like.
That dog is going to get put down.
Yeah.
You know that dog is getting put down.
Yep.
Okay, that dog will be executed for that maneuver.
Yep.
But who owns a dog that's that vicious and lets it roam around the street?
Right.
But that cat was pretty awesome.
That owner should be put down.
That cat probably saved that little boy's life.
Indeed.
That was awesome.
Very cool. It wasn't as bad as it could have been, so they're very thankful for that. As you can see from the end of the video, he does walk away.
Yeah, but still. Ugh, scary. Okay, it's science time.
Talk about science.
Speaking of getting your leg ripped off and needing prosthetic limbs.
Dean Kamen to the rescue. So Dean Kamen, if you don't know his name, is the inventor of the Segway, most notably. But he does all sorts of stuff. Charities, really cool science research projects. He is now
Plus
come
he's rolling.
Up. He is rolling. With the DECA arm. The
DECA arm?
DEKA arm.
Wow.
Now, it has been FDA approved. So prosthetics, we've seen mind-controlled prosthetics and stuff, but none of them have actually come to market. This has been approved by the FDA, and it is the first of its kind. This is, look at what he's doing. With two fingers, with the thumb and the forefinger, he is picking up an egg and moving it into another carton.
How do I know those eggs haven't been hard-boiled?
It doesn't matter. The fact that he's not dropping them is incredible for prosthetic arms.
That is true.
Arms and
I thought
hands.
What was incredible was that he wasn't crushing the egg.
Well, that's true. The sensitivity, right?
Yeah.
And so the computer in the arm, it takes the muscle impulses and converts them into actions that you see him moving his arm and moving his fingers. He gets a vibration. To know that he's touching something so that he can literally feel. So if you
That's
you know, his mind can now feel the action that he's taking. It is really, really
So that
really
means
cool.
We're one step closer to Will Smith's arm, prosthetic arm in iRobot.
Pretty much.
I will give my arm to get a robotic arm. Because I'm going to need it to fight the robots when the time comes.
Fair enough.
And I want to be able to bash people over the head with my arm like I'm Hulk. Smash, smash.
Well, if you do bash somebody in, then they are going to need new functions.
Prosthetic head?
No, they're going to need new functions with their livers.
Oh, yes, they probably will.
Their organs inside, which they now have. 3D printed devices have been designed by
Xiaoxin Chen.
Okay,
at
maybe
UC
that.
San Diego. Mr. Chen.
He created these 3D printed devices that mimic organ functions. So when implanted into the body, It can do things like detoxify blood out of a human liver.
So are you telling me that when I wear out my liver from all of my drinking, that I can just put a bunch of stickers on here and bingo, bango, no, I don't need a liver anymore?
Pretty much.
Pretty much?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
So good news for all the alcoholics out there.
Yeah, that sounds good. Now I can restart my alcoholism addiction.
And the good news is that it detoxifies, uses nanoparticles in order to destroy toxins in the organs and so that it's a healthy process.
Interesting.
Very, very cool.
Speaking of destroying things, would you destroy the FDA, the FCC? Would you destroy their access to your website by throttling them? What are your thoughts on net neutrality? We want to know.
All right, you guys, go let us know at geekbeat.tv/FameSpot. Leave us a video. You'll be played right here along with us. I don't know why you'd want. You're staring at me, John. Does that mean I get to go? Oh, hi. Welcome back to the show, guys. I hope you're doing well. Thank you for joining us. I'm Callie Lewis. That's John P. And you know what time it is.
Robot time.
Yay! All right, I've got three for you today.
Well, let's see. Let's see how many out of three could potentially kill us.
Take a look at this 3D printed quadcopter.
I like quadcopters.
Yes, I know you do. It's designed by Mirko Kovac from Imperial College in London. Hey.
I like
London.
Somewhat
of a Londoner. We have a UKer.
We have a UKer.
we met in London.
Studio.
Anyway, so this was inspired by birds building their nests, but they want to use something like this in order to, do dangerous jobs like seal nuclear waste or dirty jobs like building repair. But basically, it carries a two chemical mixture that becomes a polyurethane foam that can be sprayed on something. So
I have a question.
It has
for you.
An injector arm and it'll spray that using it.
This sounds to me like a quadcopter story, which belongs in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. And yet it is being passed off as a robot story.
All right, if you're not happy with that, I will show you a robot.
Oh, brother.
This robot is freaking awesome.
Oh,
it's called the Outrunner.
What? It's called the what? Oh, my good Lord.
The video can barely keep up with it.
Who would build this?
There are a couple versions. There is a six-leg version. It's 1.5 foot tall. It weighs 3 pounds, and it runs 10 miles an hour.
Wow.
Which most people can't do. And it will run for an hour. It's $299. This is a Kickstarter project, everyone. Go back it, because I want one of these things. Look at it. So the legs are like, they're
like sticks.
Well,
look,
yeah,
the guy's
like
trying
sticks.
To chase it.
He can't keep it up.
Are only like 3 seconds long because look at him. He's like, oh, let me run this. Dave, can I have this close-up camera for a minute?
Wait, there's another version.
No.
The 12-leg version.
Let me just say one thing. People, I know we've all seen The Matrix. Just because you saw The Matrix doesn't mean you have to build those killer robots, okay? Back to you.
The 12-leg version will go, it's 2 foot tall, it's 5 pounds, and it'll go 20 miles an hour.
That's faster than a human.
And that's only $800. I want an
$800
robot.
And that's 2 feet tall.
Can we get this for the Geek House?
So when they start building the 6 foot tall version, it's probably going to go like 60 miles an hour or something.
Yeah. It'll be awesome.
No, it will not be.
Thing.
It's not awesome. Look, that
is like
not
a little pet. It's like a little roach pet. You know how fast they go?
A little pet?
You know how roaches like scurry across the floor? I can just see this thing scurrying across the Geek House.
A roach pet.
Yeah, that's what we want.
Yes.
We want basically a pestilence of robots.
Did she say a roach pet? Is
I
it Planes, Trains, and Automobiles time
no,
yet?
No, I've got one more.
I think you gave up.
This robot was built by Ecole Polytechnique Fédérale.
Ecole Polytechnique Fédérale de la Sud Lausanne in Switzerland. You know who you
Switzerland.
Are. No, it's the Swiss. It's like a Polytechnic School. It's like a school.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Got it. This robot.
What in the heck?
Has learned to catch like a human. So now we can have robotic baseball teams.
Wait, so now we have robots that can outrun humans and catch anything.
It can actually, it can do this in 500th of a second. And it uses cameras to understand where objects are coming flying at them. And then it learns how to move its hand to go wherever the object is coming and catch it.
I'm sorry, in the chat room, Digital Phil said, my roach loves it when I rub its stomach.
What? Digital Phil, I thought you had chickens.
You're talking about pet. Is it my turn yet? She's sitting here telling us about robots that can run us down and catch us no matter what we do. You can never outrun or get away from a robot.
I really want that outrunner.
I don't want it.
But you can take it on now.
I tell you what I do want. A hover bike.
I want one of those too. That
yes, you do want one. Look at this. This is a hover bike made by AeroX. Now, I know.
Oh, Ryan actually made a good point.
What?
My little robot arm can be a bullet catcher, so it could become a bodyguard. Okay, now go.
Whatever.
Hover bike.
Maybe your robot arm can catch your pet roaches. So I know sometimes I show you guys certain things and I'm like, this is a prototype, you know, blah, blah. No, this is not a prototype.
This
you
is
can
real?
Buy one of these for delivery.
How much?
Very soon. It's $85,000.
That's
but
worth it.
For $85,000, the AeroX is the world's first real hover bike scheduled for production in 2017. So you can buy it now, but you can't actually get it until 2017. And it has twin carbon fiber rotors and a 45 mile an hour top speed. It'll run for about an hour and 15 minutes.
Nice.
And it'll hold 310 pounds. So you can put two people on it if one person is brave enough to get on it with another person, flying it around. It'll go 10 feet high if you wanted to.
Oh, nice. That sounds fun.
That's high enough.
I would totally do that.
Flip it over and kill you.
Yeah.
Okay, one last story of the day. Then, you see, I told you she's a robot. I told you she's a robot. One last story of the day. Then it's going to be time for unboxings.
Yay!
This story, you're going to like a lot, I think. This is possibly one of the coolest stories that we've got today. It's about the soft wheel. When I say soft wheel, here's what I want you to think about. Imagine that you were stuck in a wheelchair, like you are always in a wheelchair. Let's say you wanted to go somewhere over really bumpy, rocky terrain. Do you know how bumpy and rocky it would be?
I do.
It's very terrain-like.
Uh-huh.
Well, there was a guy, I don't have his name in here, I forgot, but there was a guy, believe it or not, he was a farmer, broke his pelvis.
Ooh.
He was like, ow, that hurts or something.
Right.
But guess what? I'm a farmer. I'm going to go be doing my farming. Wheelchair in it, ow, ow, ow. So guess what he did? He built these special wheels that have shock absorbers built into the wheels.
So
now, it started out on wheelchairs, and now he's got it on bikes.
Wow.
Each of the little strutty things inside the wheel is a shock absorber.
Wow.
So the whole thing bounces
so it's
around,
really
whatever.
That
awesome is
that? Cool. I think that's a first, right?
It's a three-shock, three-spoke design. It is absolutely brilliant. Watch this. See? Inside the wheel, those little things.
Yeah.
Anyway, go
that
to
really cool.
geekbit.tv/live138 and check out the video. I want to get some of those wheels.
Yeah, I want some.
I want some.
I
want
to ride to work now.
Yeah, me too.
All right. Well, we're going to ride on into the commercial break.
And pay the bills.
Back. We will have unboxings later.
Yes. Be right back. Welcome back to the show, folks. It's unboxing time.
Yay! And I think we're going to start off with a very special unboxing that's
Are
coming
we?
In from the UK.
From the UK? We have visitors from the UK.
We do.
What?
Would you grab that one down there for
this
me?
This one right here?
Yes. And
it says Fragile.
This is the special one that Dave was supposed to have. Yeah.
I'm driving.
What was Dave supposed to do?
I need Dave up on set at the moment.
Uh-oh. What does this have to do with Dave being on set?
So this is actually from the UK. It's for both of you.
It says not Dave Curley.
It's for you and Dave.
It's for the two of us?
It is. It comes in very special from Steve Thompson, our friend with the DeLorean.
He got us a laser harp.
Yay! Be careful opening this, but go ahead.
Okay.
So it's for the two of you. It's really for the two Geek Utes. House.
But it's really for the Geek House.
He knew that you guys would both enjoy it.
Okay, I'm gonna be careful.
We need to make sure he has a permanent table there.
Right.
That's a thing.
That's right. Let's see. Okay, I'm being careful.
Oh, Steve Thompson is here.
Hi, Steve. Thank you.
We weren't sure if he was going to make it.
Good day, mate. Let's see. Oh. What do we have here?
In a bread box.
Here. All right. Wait.
What?
Here we go. Okay, pull.
Okay. That's another picture of himself.
There's a lot of bubble wrap. There's a letter that says Cali.
Okay.
There you go.
There's a lot of bubble wrap going on in here, all up in this joint.
Ah.
What do you mean ah? Like you can see what's in there.
Ah.
Behind the bubble wrap.
Yes. Yes. Steve's cool.
I will tell you the story behind it as soon as you open it.
As soon as I open it?
Correct.
It's taking a little longer than expected. I apologize. I am attempting to use my knife and not damage.
Come on.
Here we go. Oh, it's got a nice frame. Look at the frame.
Look at that.
He wrapped it securely, people.
Wow, that is impressive, Steve.
I guess it was coming here.
Just for this.
It was coming here from the UK.
Yes. And sometimes things get damaged coming from the UK.
Oh my God, what is that? Wait. Oh. That has to be cut off too.
Don't peek.
Dude.
I couldn't not peek. That looks like Top Gear related to me.
Steve.
What is this?
Steve, did they have your car, dude? Did they have your car?
It won't come off.
Wow.
Holy cow.
So,
brilliant.
What this is
are the signatures of the guys from Top Gear.
And this is Steve's DeLorean.
This is Steve's DeLorean. He actually got to visit the Top Gear set and meet all of these guys. He got them to review his DeLorean.
His DeLorean, yeah.
And it should say something about that here. It says,
asked to review every geek's favorite form of transportation, the DeLorean. In just one word, the Top Gear team came up with the following. Clarkson, bald, referring to lack of paint. Hammond, bloody hell, technically two words, May. Optimistic. They were then asked to write the reviews on the picture of the car and endorse it with a signature. Clarkson signed his on the back because he's an idiot, according to James May. So these are actually autographed, and nice. I guess Clarkson's is in the middle, autographed on the back.
On the back.
That's awesome.
That is so awesome.
Don't break it.
I thought he was holding it. This is why he's not on set.
This is cool on so many levels because we're Top Gear geeks and we love the DeLorean, or at least John and I do because we appreciate good fine cinematic history.
Right.
Here, hang on. And
what?
That is awesome. Yeah, Thank you, Steve.
This is awesome. But Steve, what year is your DeLorean? Can you tell us?
There is a delay.
There is a delay usually, so.
There's a delay.
Well, that is really, really cool. We'll find a special place for
it. We'll have
it
a good place.
Geek House building.
Thank you.
Wait, where are you taking that?
Away.
You thought you were going to bring him up here and then he was going to leave empty handed? He called dibs before it was even opened. Okay, we've got, I don't know, medium.
Yes, Hawkman is right. That we do have the best viewers on the planet.
On planet Earth. Here, I'm just going to start grabbing boxes.
Do it.
Okay, here's one.
This is Callie Lewis.
Uh-oh. More Can-X stuff.
Oh, I love Can-X stuff.
Here, there's something, and here's another something.
That's right. This wasn't under embargo, was it?
I
hope not.
I don't know.
Knife.
I hope not. There are two of these.
I don't think that they are.
It's it looks like a battery.
So you guys know that we like our Can-X products. We use them.
They make good stuff.
This is the Go Power Pack. It's a portable battery. And we've got, let's see, we've got a status indicator
here. It looks like we got two sizes.
Two USB ports, micro USB there. And what is this?
There's some kind of secret hidden compartment.
What
or something.
Is this?
It's like a little tray. Now we're going to have to read the packaging. This one I have is a 6,000 milliamp battery. And it has...
It's to prop your smartphone.
A 1 amp and a 2.1 amp. So oh, that is brilliant.
That is. Look at this.
Your phone's over there.
Oh, yeah. Look. Okay, so you pull that out. It just slides right out. And voila. You can charge your phone while watching or doing something on your... How awesome is that?
That is actually a really good idea. I've never seen that before. It's so simple and yet so excellent.
So this is an 11,000 milliamp hour battery, and that is...
Plug that in there, plug that in there.
A 6,000 one.
And bingo, charging. That is brilliant,
nice.
Canx, friends.
Canx, good job.
That is a great idea. I love it. So 6,000 and how? And what's the other
11,000.
Wow, that's a big battery.
Very, very cool.
Wow, that is really cool. The model on this one is KBY10. So you guys tell us, how much is the KBY10 from Canx?
Oh, wait, I just saw the note from Steve Thompson that his DeLorean is a 1981.
Huh. There you go.
I like that year.
Yes, you do like that year.
That was the year I was born.
Okay, here we go. Next item up for grabs.
Samson!
Oh!
Is there a new meteorite?
Dibs.
Is this a new meteorite?
Yes. Yes.
I can't open anything. I need to get myself a quick key. Where is my quick key? Who stole it?
The quick keys are on order. Okay. This, now some of you may have seen our Samson Meteor microphone that we use literally every week.
Yeah.
We use it all the time.
We do, for our patron hangouts especially.
Yes, but let's say that you wanted something even more smaller and maybe more portable.
Like well, that we could take on a hotel room.
Yeah, put it in your backpack, take it with you. Well, that is where the Meteorite comes in. It is a baby little tiny.
That is so cute.
Oh, and it's magnetic.
Love it.
How awesome is that?
Nice.
It's a magnetic, it's got a little magnetic
and
base.
And you can adjust the angle. That is
yeah,
cool.
I don't know if it's that directionally sensitive, but it is a little USB.
It may look so, cooler one way or another too.
Yeah,
you.
I don't know. So the...
Does it have a mic connector? I mean, a mounting point on the
underside? I see, oh, no, it's just a weighted,
it's a weighted
little base. And I would say that if it's anything like the its bigger brother, it's going to sound fantastic. But we will not just take a guess at it; we will show it to
Absolutely.
You. So we're gonna do some testing, and we'll let you guys know.
Cool.
That thing is awesome.
Thanks, Samson.
Okay, FedEx.
All
and
right.
Now from our friends at FedEx.
Everything. Ooh.
What? What is it?
Mine.
What is it? Oh, brother.
These are from our friends at Samsung. Not Samson, the other one, Samsung.
This is the new Gear 2. So you guys may be familiar with these. This is a smartwatch that integrates with your phone and gets you, it's like, you know, the competitor to the Pebble, which I'm wearing a Pebble right there.
And this is the Gear Fit.
Oh, I have been dying to try one of those.
Yep, you don't get to.
Oh, great. Well, that's okay. I'll take the Gear 2.
Who's skipping out on the workout tomorrow,
here we go.
Huh?
Here
Who
we
needs
go.
It more?
Is that all that we got in the
no,
box?
No, actually,
like
I totally got distracted.
Dips.
Oh, and here is a Samsung Galaxy S5.
Oh, you know what happened? Okay, I have to tell this story real quick. So you guys may recall we unboxed a Galaxy S5 a few weeks ago.
Did
well,
we?
The one we unboxed was an AT&T version, and I like AT&T, but my phone service is with Verizon. And so I was really liking the phone. I was like, this phone is great. The only problem is I can't actually like switch my SIM card in it to use it all the time. They said, you know what? We'll fix that. And they sent me a Verizon version. So I'll let you know all about this later. After I'm gonna try swapping from my Note 3 to the S5 to see if I can live with it.
Nice.
You just can't even go the rest of the show.
I cannot.
So it looks like they also, in case I wanted to switch out the band for the Gear 2, there's a nice metal band, I guess.
And
and then, and a nice
little
case
S5 case
for the S5. Cool. Samsung is awesome. I don't care. I know we're supposed to be all kind of like, you know, journalistic integrity filled, whatever. I love Samsung, okay? So this looks like a computer.
Yes, this is mine too.
Boy, this is the Cali.
This is the Cali unboxing.
Hey,
so.
I got you a special present from Steve Thompson.
You did. I'm not complaining. I love how Steve, don't you love how she took credit? I got you a special gift from Steve Thompson.
What can I say? I worked with him on it, at least.
Okay. This looks like...
Right, yeah, exactly.
This looks like a Scepter laptop.
Yes.
Watch out. I've got a... Hot knife coming through. What do we have here? What do you have here? Oh, wow.
Oh, look at the packaging.
Hang on a minute.
That's nice.
Now, hang on. Grab that box. Hold on a minute.
This is nice.
That is really nice packaging.
Wow, HP.
Wow. Oh, my gosh. Look at this. The Spectre 13.
Wow.
I would have to say that if I was to buy this, I would already
impressed.
Be pretty happy right
yes,
now.
Exactly.
Okay, let's see what's in it.
All right.
Hi, Callie.
A note. The Spectre. Oh, quick tour sheet.
A quick tour sheet.
Let's see.
Let's see if we can take this out without totally destroying their plastic. That is a gorgeous, gorgeous. It feels good. It feels solid. It's got a really nice kind of aluminum finish. It's extremely thin. You see how thin that is?
Yeah, that looks
good. What's it got on it? One.
Is this a Chromebook?
Over here, no, I think this is a full Windows 8 laptop. It's got a USB. What is that? That's a display port.
Yeah.
Wait, Ken, am I looking at this correct?
That's Thunderbolt, John.
Does that have... Oh, is that Thunderbolt?
That looks like Thunderbolt.
They told us they were doing Thunderbolt and all their stuff.
Well, it's definitely HDMI, but it has a DP beside it. I think that's a HDMI and a display port. We got to look at the specs.
I'm looking for the specs.
What's over here?
But,
there's another USB headphone and an SD reader. And I just have to open it up. Oh, wow. That's a good looking screen.
This looks really good.
How big this this touchpad is.
Yes, that's one of the features of this is that it has an extra large touchpad so that you can, you know, have at it. And I am anxious to try that because I love trackpads.
It's Beats and it's got a little webcam in there too. I don't know, it looks really nice here.
Gorgeous.
I know you're gonna...
How's it feel? I mean, is it like a pound?
It's solid. It's, I'd say it's 3.5-4 pounds.
Yeah.
3.5-4 pounds, but it's a good weight and it's a beautiful finish. It looks expensive.
It does.
Is it expensive?
You guys.
How expensive is that, you guys?
13-inch.
The Scepter 13-inch.
The Ultrabook.
Okay, or Spectre. I said.
What'd you say?
Okay, we have another package here from our friends at Max Borgs.
Oh.
Let's see. What do we have in y'all?
Are they? They usually send us a few different things when we get a package from them.
Oh, this is a big old package.
What is this?
This is the FlatWave Air Outdoor Amplified HD Antenna.
Nice.
So it looks like a little kit. There is a mounting arm. And the antenna looks like would be mounted in here with a little bracket thing.
Nice.
So, I don't know what else to tell you. It's
an
antenna.
It's an outdoor antenna. There's a mounting plate.
All we can do
right
is
there.
Give it a try.
Yeah.
So, we will give that little puppy a try and see how that goes for all of you who are considering cutting the cord.
And do we have another one? That was it.
That's a lot.
That is a lot of awesomeness.
That is quite a bounty. It's quite a lot of work to do a bunch of reviews as well. So
yes, it is.
Thanks, you guys, for sticking with us through a whole hour of this craziness.
I think it was a little longer. I don't know.
It felt like a long time to you because you were with me?
Yeah.
You got your little watch already
on. I'm already wearing my
gear
fit.
She just couldn't wait. Okay, guys, you can keep up with all of our antics by following Callie on Google Plus at google.com/+CallieLewis or on Twitter. @CallieLewis,
Or you can go to google.com/plusjohnp or twitter.com/johnpose and find him or and his crazy antics.
You can also follow Geekbeat at GeekbeatTV.
Yeah.
And plus us on Google Plus while you're at it.
Indeed. Thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate the opportunity to hang out with you each and every week.
Indeed. Thanks, guys. Have a good week, and we will see you next week.
Bye.
Bye-bye.